welcome to end of the world satsang, as it were, where the opportunity for folly is great and the opportunity for wisdom is even greater. Those are the two paths that you have to choose from. Those are the two options. So let's focus in on the path of wisdom. And wisdom is that which sees good and bad as two sides of the same, very same coin, as part of one dynamic, not two different dynamics, one dynamic. One coin, two sides of the coin of existence is the good, which is the constructive, and the bad, which is the destructive. Wisdom sees those as one. Okay, when you're able to see that as one, that different perspective dawns upon you and you realize, ah, you see what your true options are. Your true option is to choose a new idea. The existence is the play of an idea, one idea, the idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality. That's what it is. But you're free to choose any other idea. You can choose the idea of not trying to replace reality. And then the play of that idea will be different. You will experience a perfect seamlessness, no fragmentation. Constructivity, destructivity can still be apparent, and yet you will not feel that they're touching the seamlessness at all, having zero effect upon it. So that's the option that the wise are going towards, choosing a new idea. Now, in looking at existence, you see it's a dance of constructivity and destructivity. Obviously, in order for destructivity to have its play, constructivity has to have its play first. You want to cut down a tree, the tree has to grow first. So, however, the primary intent of existence is to give plausible evidence that it's possible to replace reality. And it does that through destructivity. So, destructivity has the upper hand in existence. Now, the wise are those who have put aside their naivete. In order to entertain the idea of being able to replace reality, there has to be a tremendous naivete present. And in the construct, both in the constructivity and the destructivity that is present, the constructivity believes that we're an upward spiral of ever-increasing beauty and harmony and peace and love, and it's possible to build peace on earth and bring, you know, the super bring divinity here to the planet, and that will overcome the negativity. And there's an enormous naivete in that. It completely ignores the extreme adeptness of destructivity to bring constructivity into ruin and fragmentation. On the flip side of that one coin is destructivity has a naivete. It believes that it has the capacity to permanently wipe out constructivity, which is not true. Because the purpose of the idea of trying to replace reality, what it does is it has to generate continuous plausibility. Continuous plausibility. In order to do that, you have to have constructivity arise so that destructivity can then bring it down to ruin. If destructivity brought all constructivity to an end, where would the continual evidence of plausibility be? Wouldn't be there. So, even in the most intense times of destructivity, you see shoots of new constructivity branching out. For instance, if a planet is going to be wiped out, you will find people leaving the planet, going elsewhere, and other dimensions, other planets, etc., and seeding new constructivity in those places to build up another scenario, which in its turn will be destroyed. That's the dance of existence, constructivity, destructivity. Now, many have been observing this dance for a long time, and they're very tired of it. Ultimately, this idea that we're trying to experience, the idea of replacing reality with a new reality, is futile, 100% futile, and therefore it's boring. Very boring. In fact, perfectly boring, which is an intolerable feeling. When you reach that feeling of total boredom, then you sober up, as I call it. You reach a new level of sobriety where you become incredibly eager to find real answers. And you will pursue those real answers, and that's when you begin to tune in to real teachers who will point out the actual facts of the situation. Now, waking up just really means clarifying what your options are. That's what it really is. And you gradually start realizing, you know what? I could just choose a new idea. That's my real option. It's not that I need to support constructivity and protect it from destructivity and try to build a paradise somewhere that's free from destructivity. That's folly. And it's not that I need to try and empower destructivity to carry out some final annihilation of constructivity to prove that reality can be destroyed, because that never works either. It's always, someone always escapes, you know, constructivity always escapes somewhere and seeds new constructivity elsewhere. Both of those are folly. And blending the two is also folly, because it's just more of a gentler dance, so to speak, you know, of construction, destruction. It's still going on. Getting nowhere. Seeing that, seeing the futility of it, leads you to then say, wait a minute, I need to take a step back, look at the bigger picture, and then you realize, my option. You remember your option. Your functionality in reality is to choose ideas. And you've forgotten that. And your incredible naivete, which is necessary, again, for this entire hypothetical scenario of plausibility to interest you. Because you can, at any moment, you can choose a new idea. Any moment. So you have to, this idea has to keep you interested in it, so that you'll continue to choose this idea and say, I want to keep experiencing this idea. It has to make it seem plausible what's taking place. And in order to seem plausible, there has to be this naivete. If you look at the constructive aspect of it, people who are very constructive, very positive, optimistic, you know, they're saying, we're really going to make so much progress and build some, you know, great society and all of this, bring the divinity here to this world. They're called spiritual people. But pursuing spirituality is incredibly naive, okay? Just as pursuing extreme darkness is incredibly naive too, isn't it? Both of those are very naive, okay? That's not wisdom. Don't think that you need to pursue a path of spirituality, because that's just constructivity, which is entirely vulnerable to destructivity. Rather, pursue the path of awakening to your options. Seeing, I call it the path of clarity. Clarify what your options really are, and then you will eventually start to wake up and say, I can choose a new idea. Of course, it's folly to try and manipulate the effects of one idea and make them seem like it's the effects of some other idea. It's foolishness. That's like trying to protect your feet from thorns and pebbles and such by trying to remove all the little thorns and stickers and pebbles from the world instead of putting on a pair of shoes. You know, just put on a pair of shoes. It's like that. Just choose a new idea. It's the only way that actually works, because that new idea will carry with it the effects of that idea. It won't be some other effects. It'll be the effects of that idea. And the idea of not trying to replace reality will carry with it the effects of that idea. And it'll be a wonderful feeling of seamlessness. Perfect seamlessness. Effortless seamlessness. So now we've come to the second half of 2011, where the dance of constructivity and destructivity is going to be heavily weighted towards destructivity. Started in November of 2010. That heavy intensity. And it's going to accelerate now tremendously. Okay, and then you're going to become very much aware that you need to choose an option. And there will be those who say, join us in our path to create a new world. And there'll be those who say, join us in our path to tear down this one so we can build a new one on the ashes of this one. And there'll be all types of options, and yet the option of wisdom will be there too, and saying, ah, see that constructivity and destructivity are just one dance, and it's a dance of futility, because reality cannot be replaced. So rather choose the idea of not trying to replace reality, and that'll truly be your salvation. Now, is it easy to see this clearly? No, it's not. It's a challenge. But it's the only challenge really worth accepting. Because anything else, you're merely listening to the same old song over and over and over and over and over again. And the boredom will always be lurking there. And you'll be terrified of the boredom. You'll do anything to avoid it. But the wise are those who have faced the boredom and realize that it is there and it's intolerable, and therefore they realize they really, really have to find the right answer, the true answer, and they're determined to do so. Then you have that extra push of momentum, so you'll no longer engage in the folly of the world, the constructive push and the destructive push. You're not part of either one of those. I'm not part of either one of those. Never have been here. Say, no, I said, forget it. Constructivity, forget it. Destructivity, forget it. There's a third aspect, which is wisdom. And the world will ask you, you know, which camp are you in? You're the part of the constructives or the destructives? And you can say neither, and they don't understand what you're talking about. So the destructives will look at you and say, ah, you're part of the constructives. And the constructives will look at you and say, ah, you're part of the destructives. So you don't fit in anywhere. You don't fit in anywhere. But you got to realize you're part of wisdom. You're part of clarity, clarification. You're part of the clarifiers. About a year and a half ago, I started this new spiritual option in this world, new option called clarity. And I say, you can call yourself a clariton. You're neither a constructive nor a destructive. You're trying to blend the two. You're a clariton. You're trying to clarify what your options are. And as difficult as it is to clarify, it's not nearly as bad as feeling that terrible boredom, being stuck in constructivity and destructivity, and the futility of it. That's much, much worse. So really, taking up the challenge of clarification is by far and away the best option that you have or will ever have in existence. Never come across a better option, as difficult as it may seem, so you might as well get after it. And that's what we're making available here. Get after that wisdom and assimilate it. It's like sitting in the sun getting a tan. It's gradual, but it does eventually take place. Okay, that's it for now.